Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. It is your host Francesco D'Alessio and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So guys, today we are reviewing an application that is in front of me here. It's called Why Productive. This is something that I discovered on Product Hunt maybe a few months ago actually now. It got Product of the Day from my memory, and it quite interested me mainly because it's one of the productivity applications that look rather attractive. And it certainly does sort of entice many people. Now, the application is really simple. It tries to combine tasks with tracking, so time tracking your daily routine. So what we'll be doing today is a full review of the application. It is an application available on macOS, Windows, Chrome, Safari, and Firefox as extensions. Why Productive did send me over a 30% discount in case anyone's interested, so I'll include that one in the description below. It should also be available through our deals page now. So I think it's 30% off, but you'll have to find that one out below. Anyway guys, this is going to be a full review, so let's jump in. If you want to skip ahead to a certain element of this, feel free to use the timestamps below. So here we are with the Mac OS application. I was playing around with it a little sort of last week period while I was doing a bit of research on it. First off, I want to say it's such a good design. Not many of these sort of tracking applications have a beautiful design. There are a few ones out there that do, but this is an install, and once you install it, you have to give it permission to track some of your activity. So I'll include the privacy information below, the link to that sort of stuff. As you can see in front of you, this is what you arrive on when you create an account. So essentially you've got, in the top left-hand corner, you've got tasks, categories, and reports. Now tasks is your sort of dashboard, your starting point. As you can see here, you've got almost this like workday view. So you've got a timeline of your activity spent. And it says up here that I've done 4 hours, 10 minutes. And that's the time you spent on the computer. And your course you can log separately to that. Now as you can see here, obviously my day started quite early this morning. And what I can do is once I click into this sort of timeline view, I can see all of the time that was spent this morning. I can see all of the activities if I want. But what it's done quite smartly is it's categorized some of them. It's automatically detected some of the work as unproductive and most of it as uncategorized. So you can train it essentially to learn about your pieces. Now, the exciting thing here is you can assign it to a task. So if you have a task, which we'll explain in a minute, inside of this area, you can give it to that area. So for example, if you did a bunch of like, for example, scripting YouTube, if I wanted to associate it to that time, I can type it in. And as you can see, all of those tasks were associated, all those activities were associated there. And down here, I can see that an hour and a half was spent on that specific item. And it's updated this in the top right-hand corner, spent on task time. Now, of course, it does analyze your productive time by going through the websites and applications that you're using. Of course, it will use tracking of the applications you're using natively, as well as the websites you're visiting. So hopefully, you get a good idea of what you're actually on. Down here, just below it, you've got a breakdown. You see P, U, and uncategorized. Productive is P, U is unproductive. And you can see here that I spent a lot of time on YouTube and Facebook this morning. Mainly uploading something on YouTube, but as you can see, I've spent 9 minutes on Facebook today and 3 minutes on Twitter. You can also click the all category, and over here on the right, you can see that I spent an hour and a half on Go Skills, planning creating a course. Microsoft Word, I've been on 20 minutes. Camtasia, I've been on. And what you can do with that next to it, if you can categorize it, so for example, I'm going to click productive time for Go Skills, productive time for Microsoft Word. I'm going to say Instagram's unproductive, and obviously you can go through this and clear it, and over time it will start basically learning which ones are unproductive and productive, and it will make a sort of optimized experience for you. Now the great thing is if I click hide, you can start seeing down here that it's giving me a productive score or a rating. So you can see that all that period of time that I worked on and it was associated to this task, the scripting of the YouTube, It's given me a 48% productivity rating. So for example, if I detected, if I went on and changed this a little, it would obviously update and tweak that, which is very helpful. So you're probably wondering so far what this sort of compares to. So far at the moment, I would say it compares to sort of like Toggle to some extent. I did a review of Toggle a few weeks ago, and obviously it has this timeline function and the ability to sort of track the websites. And it does have a few elements that sort of reign similar. There is a task experience in this, which obviously allows you to start tracking. So for example, down here, let's dive into the task side of stuff. If I wanted to add a new task, I could do that, and I can add it to a certain due date today, or for example, a project as well. So for example, let's just say record 1x YouTube as an activity, associate it to YouTube work, and put it as today, and click add task. What you can do is you can start that timer, and as you can see, the timer has started, and of course, it will start tracking it from here, and anything that is in this period of time, it will obviously start associating it to that time. So for example, if I click onto the top, you can see that I'm recording 1x YouTube, I'm inside of Why Productive, and at the moment, because Why Productive is a productive task, I'm getting 100% productivity. But for example, what it will do is it will automatically detect switching and obviously give that a poor rating, if that makes sense. So for example, if I switch between applications, like an unproductive application, it will not, the score will go down. So for example, if I'm like, I switch between that one, you can see that my productivity score has been dented because over here, I switched to an uncategorized application called Twist, and uncategorized gave it 5% of the activity. So it does analyze that, and it's quite smart with doing that. So essentially you can just minimize this and basically get on with your activity, come back to it and go, actually, I went on Facebook 3x, I didn't even notice that. So it's quite a neat application for that. Now you're probably wondering, how do I do this on scale? How do I start adding activities manually? How do I start really fine tuning this? Obviously it'll take a bit of time, but what you can do is go up to categories in the top left-hand corner and start dragging stuff across. Like for example, this one is the Squarespace website where we upload blog posts. I'd say email, I'm gonna put email as productive because I guess it's productive. I'm gonna put some of the ones here. So I'm gonna put Todoist is productive. I'm gonna put that one is productive. Most of these are productive. I'm gonna say buffer because that's sort of like a Twist is productive to some extent. You can see where I'm coming from. I'm gonna say Spotify is unproductive. I'm gonna say Google's productive, etc. And as you can see here, I've able to categorize everything pretty rapidly. Which is very, 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 very helpful. Now, if I go back, that obviously changes everything up. And you can see here that I've switched a total of 22 times today, which gives my productivity score a lower rating. As you can see, everything's gone up. 63% of the day has been productive time so far. And if I wanted to, I could go back and associate them to specific time as well. If I had a meeting or a task, then I could do so there. Now you're probably wondering, how do projects work? Projects are really simple. So for example, we'll go in this project. I can see exactly how much time is spent so far on this project and activities, the productive time and the average productivity rating. I can then add tasks if I wanted to, and I could do the same for any other project that I create. They're really simple to create projects. So up in the top left-hand corner, I do have all tasks, today view and history. So I can go back to a certain day if I wanted to. So for example, this is the day that I tracked the other bit of the day, and I could see here that I had a few elements of productive time, but I can always go back to a certain day if I wanted to. Now up here you have reports, so you can basically see, so for example, this is this week, I'm gonna go on the last week. You can see here that I spent all of this time, 3 minutes, on the elements here, and you can see a breakdown of that. So for example, if you're able to, you know, for example, get this week, you can see that Wednesday so far has been 1.5 hours on YouTube work, and you can see a sort of breakdown of what you've spent your time on per project and per task. Now, of course, you can break down per project, which is quite nice, using the sorting features and whatever day you want there. Now, the great thing is once you've started that timer, you can pause from up here, you can start a new task as well, for example, and you can show Why Productive from here. Now, the application does give you a 14-day free trial, but of course you have the browser extensions. So for example, let's demonstrate that for you now. So the browser extension is really simple. It's allowing you to essentially focus on your activities. So this is quite a nice extension of the experience. You can use this on Firefox, Safari, or Chrome. You hit the focus mode button, and once it's on, whenever you're using the browser activity, so for example, you're searching something, what it will do is it will potentially block websites that you want. So for example, let's give this a little bit of a test. So as you can see here, guys, it's blocked YouTube. That was one of the unproductive categories that I set it as. And as you can imagine, it blocks the site, which is quite helpful whenever you've got focus mode on, and it will log it to that you tried getting on that one naturally. And that's quite good. I find that quite a beneficial experience. As you can see here, you can see that it logged the blocked by focus mode time period. So that's quite a helpful experience, and it obviously gives you an update on your score. Now, if you wanted to, for example, I know that I've completed this task, you can complete an item and it will be stricken off inside of the application. So guys, this application is obviously fairly new, but the sort of goal is it to help you keep track of your productive and unproductive time, as well as keep you on task too. Now, the application was fairly impressive to me. For example, the design was something that really stood out to me, and I would also say the experience as well. The sort of whole package of it, using the Chrome extensions and also using this Mac application, sort of felt like an experience more than it did necessarily one of the other resources. And I can imagine that a lot of people will be looking at this application as a alternative, mainly because of the task function that helps you set out your task and also assign previous items to it. Now, the team have mentioned in their roadmap that they're working on a Pomodoro timer. They've mentioned they're working on time frame based focus mode. They're working on idle detection too. That's away from the keyboard function. They're working on the dark mode as well as goals, and they're working on local and cloud storage options. Now, as I said, this application has a 14-day free trial, and you can download it for free as well on Mac, Windows, as well as the browser extensions too. The browser extensions are more of an additional experience to it, just to note that. Now, as I mentioned, there will be a 30% off discount below, so you can check that one out. And of course, that will obviously give you 30% off. I think it's yearly accounts. When you subscribe to the application. So the pricing is fairly reasonable. The monthly subscription is €7 per month. You've got a 3-month subscription, which is €18 for those 3 months, which works out about €6 per month. And you've also got the lifetime account, which is €59, which will give you access forever to all of the experience. Now, obviously this is very early days. I'm impressed by this application. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it, whether you've tried it out, whether you're interested in it. Pop them in the comments below. If you're brand new to this channel, I do recommend subscribing. We do plenty of features like this, and it'd be great to have you as a subscriber. You can also join the Facebook group as well as my own personal channel here on YouTube. It'd be great to have you on all of those, so I'll include them in the description below. Anyway, guys, a huge thanks for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.